New episode of NTB Dialogues, which is a series of thought-provoking and insightful interviews with leaders to accelerate the fight against tuberculosis. Today we are very honored to have with us Dr. Tushar Kantire. We are indeed honored to have with us Tushar Kanti Ray, who is a public health social scientist and has been involved in TB care and control for nearly 3 decades and has worked in over 30 countries in this field. Welcome, Tushar. He is also a TB survivor. Tushar, can you share with us your experience as a survivor and your work in this field? What have been the major highlights and challenges both which you have seen?
In fact, when I was a postgraduate student, I suffered with tuberculosis with a pleural effusion, and at that time I have been treated with all first line drug. At that moment, though there was no standard regimen, but I have been treated for 9 months with 5-drug combination, with 90 days with streptomycin, and that was my first exposure to TB as a student.
When was that?
Which it was in 1981. Then during mid-90s, I get involved with public health activity in India, with working with DANIDA. DANIDA means the Danish International Development Assistance, is the Danish Foreign Ministry supporting various health and other development activity in India as a bilateral support. I was part of the mission. So I get involved initially with the leprosy program, and when subsequently start involving myself from the beginning of RNTCP in India with developing and supporting TB control program based on DOT strategy, which is known as the RNTCP. And DANIDA was focusing on state of Orissa, so I was the advisor for the state. Mm-hmm. And we closely working with the government of Orissa as well as government of India to start the DOTS program initially with the tribal districts and subsequently to the whole of the state. So that was my beginning.
We find that despite all the work being done, a lot of progress being made, we are still falling short of achieving the targets for even 2022, and India has promised to end tuberculosis by 2025. What are the challenges you foresee or you can share from your own experience which are actually preventing us from reaching that goal of ending TB?
See, the major challenge, India is having a huge pool of tuberculosis patients, and almost 40 to 50% of its population are infected with latent tuberculosis. That is a major challenge. In addition to that, the quite a large proportion of our population of India are with substandard living in terms of food, in terms of housing, in terms of education, in terms of healthcare, access to healthcare. So these are the contributing factor to the problem of tuberculosis. In the beginning of 2000, China was having highest number of tuberculosis patient in the world, and second was India, but China has gone down drastically, but India remain very high. This is a major challenge because pool is a big pool of tuberculosis. They need to be not only need to be treated, need to be also provided other kind of, we need to work on not only medical point of view, also other aspects, socio-economic development and things are required. And so that is, and if among the economic recession, if in during the economic tragedy, the problem is expected to increase, and the problem becoming more worse. We need to now, at the moment, we need to also focus in this present economic state of the country, what will happen, how we are going to address the problem. It is a right that this year the International Union for Tuberculosis and Lung Disease has done this international conference in India, focusing India into the picture. So that is a good, but It is a huge task. It is not only the government of India, the state, the provincial government, the state government, the municipality, the panchayat has to get involved for next 4-5, maybe 5-7 years so that we can able to address this problem.
Tushar, you have rightly pointed out two major hurdles. One is the pool of people infected with latent tuberculosis, and also the social enablers of TB which we have to tackle. Can you elaborate a little more on latent TB? How do we empty that pool, or at least try to empty, because every new infection of TB comes from, of active TB comes from this pool. So what does India need to do more? What do we all need to do more on that?
See, the latent tuberculosis, addressing the problem of latent tuberculosis is a very new concept in so far the India is concerned. And providing the intensifying, or you can say the prophylaxis treatment. So we need new drugs and new technology. Mostly new drug and reaching the people and identifying who are the latent and how to identify them. That is the major challenge. At the moment, the technology we have is very difficult to identify who are latent tuberculosis. But we can say the within the family, within the where we have a TB patient, within the community, we need to frequently screen the community, screen the family member, and try to address the problem based on the symptomatics. Any symptomatics, we should see that latent tuberculosis is being addressed. Then the question of new drug, at the moment we are using only one drug, which is INH. INH has its own limitations, but with the invent of new drug, and if the drug price will come down and mass production takes place in country like Indian pharmaceutical companies start manufacturing and selling at a much cheaper price, and government of India and other agency can get involved. And so that is one area we need to focus. One is identifying the latent and treating them.
And this may be difficult in the sense that we are actually trying to focus on people who are seemingly healthy. They don't have a risk perception of TB because they don't have any symptoms. So do you think it is better to first test them for latent TB and then treat, or just give them treatment?
No, it is this is a big debate issue, whether we have to state give and it is, or we have to test them. The question is that the huge pool to reaching all the people, giving the new drug to the, all the people, it is also, we need to have evidence. At the moment, we don't have an evidence-based operational studies are not there in India. Maybe you can find out in some other country, in America, the population is, but in country like India, we don't have a study. We have to have more pilots, then we can think of how we can go to the, then also the question of procurement, drug requirement, funding requirement, operational issues. Is not only procuring drug, will also solve the operational issues, how you restrict the people. Though we have, India has a history addressing the problem of polio. We have done, we have, it's a good achievement. But polio was again a different way it has to be seen. So it is an issue. We need to have few pilots in different settings, and then we can develop some methodology.
Do we need better diagnostic tests to diagnose latent TB? What are the tests available?
There are till now we are not. I don't know particularly the better diagnostics available, or, but we know that the people, the family, those who are suffering from, anyone is suffering from TB, there's a the pool of infection, the question of infecting the people, get infected.
Yes.
That mapping has to be done.
Right.
So who is being infected by the TB patient, and where this patient got infection. So a mapping need to be done, and then we can reach to them, to this address they'll attend.
So mapping is important, just to identify the people first who have latent TB, and then
can say that 100% we cannot say the latent TB, but we can say who are the presumptive latent TB.
High risk
population. Those high risk population, for example HIV, they are the high risk population. They should go for immediately without any test. We can straight away go for the latent TB.
Anything else you would suggest how to sort of accelerate this fight against TB? Something from your own personal experience that probably you experienced tuberculosis twice. Was it? I do not know about that, but you were there. So can you share that?
Let's see. I have worked in, as you have already know, that I have worked in many countries. I have visited many sites. I have interacted with. I've interacted with many patients in many country. I've also interacted with MDR patient, XDR patient. So, but what happened a couple of year back? I have some problem with my liver, and I wanted to know why my liver has a problem. So it took me almost a year with various diagnosis. We could not able to find out the reason. The problem with my liver, when liver biopsy has been done, it has been found that my liver is infected with tuberculosis. So this hepatic TB is, I'm suffering, and I've just finished my treatment with modified ATT with 9 month course treatment. I've just finished my treatment. So there are certain kind of TB, it is so difficult to diagnose, because probably the latent TB would have been there maybe after, that may be the reason. So this need to be addressed very seriously, and we have to not only focus only the public health aspect, also we have to think the clinically and infection, how it is going, which part of the body is going, and there are a lot of people are still in a dormant state, they don't know. I didn't have any sign and symptom, but I suffered TB. I found TB after many diagnostic tests done, not for TB, but subsequently when we found. So there are issues, there are concerns are there.
And probably it is more difficult to diagnose extrapulmonary tuberculosis, which you had. Yes.
Even if extrapulmonary, there are some clinically can be diagnosed some of this, but there are tests has to be done, there are many other things, there are many people are also having TB in the bone, but very late they have been diagnosed, by the time lot of damage has been done. So those we need to also focus on how to increase better diagnosis for extrapulmonary.
Because for pulmonary TB we have good diagnostics, but for extrapulmonary it becomes difficult. And maybe also your liver getting affected, as you said, you could be harboring the latent TB bacteria there, or even the medicines which you took there, they might have had some toxic effect on the liver.
See, the treatment, hepatic TB treatment is a very difficult, because most of this anti-TB drug are problematic to the water. So the what we call it is hepatotoxic. Most of the drugs are hepatotoxic. So treating also a patient with TB with liver is also very carefully you have to do. You cannot do the same treatment like you do. So what they have done, they have taken out one hepatotoxic drug, added another non-hepatotoxic drug, then they've observed for few weeks how it is impact on my treatment, then they started extending that treatment. So hepatotoxic is a major issue with the liver as well as also with the kidney also, there's a problem.
So did you get treated in India, or you had the facility of getting treated abroad, or the medicine?
I have been diagnosed in India. We have a institute in Delhi, Institute of Liver and Biliary Science. This is a very specialized institute where they could able to diagnose my TB in liver, and the treatment has been also prescribed by them. After that, I consulted many people, in many doctors in India and abroad. I didn't get a clear-cut answer from them. Though finally, I decided, in consultation with the Institute of Liver and Biliary Science, the doctor, I took my treatment. I'm now better. Okay. Yeah.
Your message for this, you said it is good to have this 50th Union World Health Conference, Lung Health Conference in India, in Hyderabad. Any message for this conference which can sort of increase our efforts towards ending tuberculosis?
This conference is one of thing pioneer in worldwide, bringing many experts, public health expert, clinical expert, and also scientists to the together discuss and find out many things. But in the meantime, we also focus more how to, whatever the efforts are being done, how it will percolating down to the people and patient, because a lot of things are happening at the international level, at the national level, but when it is coming down to the patient level, to the community level, very few things are percolating down. So we need to more efforts to that, how it has to percolating down to the community level and patient level. That is my
I think that's a very important point you have made, because unless we have local action and unless diagnostics, treatment, they reach the people who they are intended for, it will be difficult. So thank you, Tushar, for being with us today. Friends, we were listening to Tushar Kanti Ray, a TB expert who has worked in the field of TB care and control for over 30 years. He was with us in this NTB dialogue series of CNS. Thank you for being with us.
Done?
Done.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.